When we talk about media manipulation, though, whether it's Trump or Avenatti or anybody else, I think the point is just to be more skeptical of the manipulation that's going on. Right.
Fooled him again.
I really cannot stand this guy. There is an actual psychological term for what he's doing right here, and it's called projection. It's when manipulative people accuse you of what they are actively engaged in. I've also heard this quote attributed to Saul Alinsky in his book Rules for Radicals, as well as Karl Marx, Goebbels, and Lenin, although I haven't been able to verify any of those. Regardless, if this is in fact from Rules for Radicals, it wouldn't at all surprise me that Stelter and other fake journalists are regular practitioners of this tactic. Really quickly, before we move on, I just wanted to take a quick moment to thank all my Patreon subscribers. Without all of you, none of this would be possible. If you're interested in joining us in this mission to expose the media's corruption, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon or Subscribestar. You can find all the links in the description and pinned comment. Thanks again. After serving as Avenatti's personal propaganda and even encouraging him to enter politics, I'm guessing Zucker told Lil Brian to get out there and spin some BS to deflect blame onto Trump and paint any doubters as insane right-wing conspiracy theorists.
I've been getting some grief from Sean Hannity this weekend, speaking of Fox, right? From Hannity for once suggesting that I thought Avenatti could be a serious candidate for president. So give me a media critique. Was that stupid on my part?
Yes, Brian, you are stupid. And yes, we all see through your bargain basement version of propaganda.
One of the weird and in many cases distressing things that Trump has done is basically to Trumpify his opposition as well. And you see this very often in the conspiratorial mindset.
Who the hell are these two stiffs? I'm getting a real weird vibe from both of them. Now Trump's opposition isn't even responsible for their own actions. Apparently now Trump's responsible for what his opposition says and does. That's not a conspiracy theory. And speaking of conspiracy theories, CNN and Brian Stelter himself are no strangers to them. On Stelter's own show, they've floated conspiracy theories such as Trump's America is USSR plus Hitler, despite the fact that all the commies are in the Democrat Party. They said Trump is a cult leader who's using mind control. They've said that Trump is a mental case that's killed more people than Hitler, Stalin, and Mao combined.
Trump is as destructive a person in this century as Hitler, Stalin, and Mao were in the last century. He may be responsible for many more million deaths than they were.
And let's not forget CNN's many, many Russian collusion stories that turned out to be complete bunk. So, as usual, CNN deflects from its own deceptions by accusing their opposition of being deceptive. It wasn't just CNN that fell in love with Avenatti either. It was the rest of the Democrat Party media complex.
Joining us once again is Michael Avenatti.
Let's bring in Michael Avenatti.
Michael Avenatti.
Michael Avenatti.
Michael Avenatti, thank you very much.
He's out there saving the country.
Don Meacham says he may be the savior of the republic.
I owe Michael Avenatti an apology. I've been saying enough already, Michael. I've seen you everywhere. What do you have left to say? I was wrong, brother. You have a lot to say.
Avenatti's a beast.
Okay, that's true.
And
he's a beast.
He's a beast.
I hand it to her, and I hand it to Michael Avenatti.
But he has a great bigger calling here. That being a lawyer is minimal compared to what he's doing.
No one has talked tougher directly to Donald Trump on TV than Michael Avenatti.
Running for president?
One reason why I'm taking you seriously as a contender is because of your presence on cable news.
I will say, as much as I dislike Fox News, they were at least out there criticizing him, while CNN, MSNBC, and the rest were all pumped up over him. The real issue here is that our so-called fourth estate tends to fall for anything that confirms their biases and gives them a weapon against Trump or Republicans. Avenatti is just the latest, most hilarious example. So of course they're out there trying to deflect from that with a little sleight of hand. Instead of just reporting on all the shadiness around Avenatti, they saw an opportunity to take out Trump, and as usual, their blind partisanship came back to bite them. That's all I got for you today, folks. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.